Welcome back to the channel. We're right back at it with Red Dead Redemption 2. There we go. I finally said it. We're in Ansburg right now, currently. Horses over here. I think we gotta go see Dutch. But we can see this guy to do that fishing thing, but I don't know if we should do that one or just go to Dutch and get that mission done, because this is like... Yeah, I think we're just going to do the Dutch one. Just because, well, this dude's time is kind of limited. And so apparently if you pay for the bounty, you can use a stagecoach to get around. That's interesting. Probably help with the fast travel and stuff like that, but it's amazing. I did 48 hours into this game and I'm finally figuring out some of this shit. God, I wish this thing would stop doing that. I'm trying to keep this definitely under an hour today. I don't want it going over. In fact, if I can keep it under 40 minutes, I'd be happy with that. Because hour and 16 minutes yesterday, it was a bit much. But pretty exciting episode nonetheless. Fucking Murphys. Well, that was interesting. We're going to get the proper attire for him. He's missing his hat. Go see what Dutch has got.
Morning, Arthur.
Mr. Morgan.
Miss Grimshaw.
You okay?
Sure.
Mr. Bell seems to have found a couple of men he knows. They're sitting over there.
Really?
Dutch seems fine with it, but it feels odd to me.
Yes, very odd.
That's it. I can use the company.
Well, at least you ain't run off.
What you talking about?
Pearson left.
Old uncle.
The traitors. Both gone at dawn. They said young Tilly they were running to save themselves. I think Mary Beth left as well.
So it goes.
They are goddamn cowards, Arthur. Cowards. All the time we spent to run off.
Well, I guess they don't want to die, Dutch.
Ain't nobody gonna... This is a tough time. And you ain't doing too well. But we, our community, we will survive. They will not crush us.
I hope so. But if we let Jack and the women free, well, then
there
maybe
ain't
we
no
can...
Freedom for no one in this country no more, Arthur. One more big score, we got enough money to leave. All this turmoil has the army and Pinkerton spinning. We take a boat and slip away.
I don't know what you're saying, Dutch, but it seems like I've heard it all before.
Just one more.
That's always a goddamn train.
Arthur, this is different. We know this is full of cash. Army payroll, money and supplies to repair the bridge that you blew. This is all going to plan. We rob Uncle Sam and we leave. The poetry of it all. What do you think?
It sounds wonderful. Hell yeah, I ain't got much to lose, but you know, the women and the children and John and his family, I'm afraid I have to insist. I mean, we gotta let them go, because if the Pinkertons come through again, they will kill everyone.
John? Insist?
Yeah. Insist.
Of course, pal. Whatever you think is best, I will see to it. Huh? Now, are we gonna rob a train?
Sure.
We will survive. We will flourish. We have work to do, my friends. Let's go. Come on. We are gonna borrow a little money from old Uncle Sam and be out of his hair once and for all. He insists. Let's ride out, gentlemen. Yeah. Let's go. Yeah.
If this is a long mission, more than likely we'll just do this mission.
Okay.
Because I'm not pushing it like I did before.
Patrol past Annisburg, waiting down by the river to collect the money.
We sneak on quietly, and then we got a short time to stop the train before it reaches the patrol.
Just gonna stop this real quick, because look how far we've traveled. And I just want to get that waypoint on. Unnecessary.
Go get that dynamite. We'll meet back up outside of Saint Denis.
I'll go with him.
As you wish.
Come on. It's this way. I hid the wagon down here after we blew the bridge.
This is one big goddamn group of us to be riding back into Saint Denis.
Yeah. I heard the Pinkertons have pretty much taken over Van Horn. Moved a whole heap of men in there. Things are closing in fast.
Shit.
Should be just through these trees. There it is. I'll get the dynamite.
No, I can do it.
Sure?
I'm fine.
Okay,
in the back.
So listen, Abigail just told me, the money, it's hidden in the caves at Beaver Hollow.
What?
Yeah, so much for never hiding it near camp. Dutch was getting even sloppier than we thought.
Are Abigail and Jack ready to leave?
I think so.
Okay. Whatever happens with this job today, wherever Dutch and them go next, we're getting you the hell out of here. We're gonna get you the money you need. Knowing the three of you got out, well, maybe all of this will still mean something. Tilly and Susan, too. I'll do whatever it takes.
You've always had my back, Arthur.
Perhaps not always.
Anyway, here we go. One last train, Arthur.
Yeah.
One last train.
I think that's literal this time. Right, like all these fucking horses.
Saint Denis. Good to be back. Happy memories, huh, John?
Will you shut up, Macca? That's enough. Quiet, all of you. Not much further now. Sadie, you board halfway along. John, you and Arthur are gonna board at the back. Rest of you, follow Mike and I, and join once they stop the train.
Here she comes.
Should I just sneak on now? God damn it. Well, everybody mount up!
We're still going through with this?
Of course we are!
Come on, Arthur! We gotta get on that train!
attention?
Of course not.
Let's get to the front. Come on.
Shot him right in the face. Thing caught fire. Yeah, so they say.
Okay, quick. Let's blow up over. Let's go. The money's in their carriage.
Ah! Come on!
Hey!
I did it right this time.
Let's move.
Where's John?
I tried.
He didn't make it.
Right.
That patrol killed him. We had to run.
Come on. Let's go. Before another patrol turns up.
You know, Dutch is lying. But what are you gonna do?
Sorry to hear that.
We gotta let her go. John's, well, sorry, son. Without John, she's just bait. Got a bunch of money, Dutch. She's just a girl. They won't do nothing to her. But me and the boys know.
Yep.
We need to keep riding on this one, Dutch. You know it. Every man here knows
it. Just gonna let the boy be made an orphan?
It ain't like that. So what is it like?
I wanna live, cowpoke. I still got the choice, Dutch. It's just a girl.
You're right. it pains me to say it, Arthur. But he's right.
Touch!
Come on, boys.
Yeah!
Well, I guess that's that then. All them goddamn years.
Come on, Arthur. Let's go get her. You and me's all we need.
Miss Tilly. Here, take this. You take this money, too. Take Jack, and you wait at Copperhead Landing for Abigail and Mrs. Adler.
Thank you, Arthur.
You're a good girl. You live a good life now, you hear?
All right, Arthur. I'll miss...
Me too, sweetheart. Me too. Jack, come here. Be brave, son. I'm gonna go get your mama.
Mrs. Adler... Ride with me.
Nice.
If they're putting her on a boat, they'll probably dock at the north end of town. So I reckon we should go in the other way.
Sure, I guess. I don't know. God, those goddamn bastards.
Look, just follow me, okay? We're gonna get this done, Arthur.
He don't care if he orphans his friend's child, so long as he gets rich. All his goddamn talk all them years. Seems like it was always a lie. Or he went crazy. What a mess.
Sure. Guess he began to believe he was God or something.
I don't know. I'm sorry you got dragged into this. Into us.
Listen. If you hadn't shown up in my house that night, I'd be dead. And even this bullshit beats dead.
The thought... I... I can find a way to get John, Abigail, and Jack out of this mess.
That's funny. I don't care who you are.
Seems I left it too late.
If we could still get Abigail, maybe her and Jack will be okay.
John, Hosea, Mac, Avi, Jenny, Sean, Lenny, we have to put an end to this. An eagle flies, another angry fool he used just like he did with the rest of us.
Like I said, Arthur, we don't need them. We're gonna make this right, me and you together. What's left of it. Now come on. Ditch the horses and come up with a plan. Easy. How you feeling?
I'm okay.
I think you should cover me and I'll go in there and get her. Because you're the better shot, I mean.
That ain't what you mean. I can still fight.
I know, Arthur. But just do it my way, honey. It's for the best. Get up someplace high, like the lighthouse or something. And cover me. Please.
Okay.
Get.
There we go.
Okay, Mr. Milton, where are you?
Let's see if I can do this without fucking up.
You are, you bastard.
Where's the other one? Got him. Doing pretty fucking good.
Shit. Mr. Milton. I guess we're gonna have to talk this out like gentlemen.
God, I knew I was gonna fucking die. It's okay. We can retry checkpoint. I don't know what I'm fucking doing. I'm having a rough go at it. I'm trying to do Deadeye and it won't fucking let me. Got good range, but not that much range.
You're a dead man.
Mr. Morgan? That's quite a cough.
Sure. Tuberculosis. I'll be dead soon. And you with me, Mr. Milton?
You'll be dead, sure. But I'm gonna be just fine. We offered you a deal, Mr. Morgan. You should have taken it.
I'm a fool, Mr. Milton.
Not all you boys have quite so many scruples. Old Micah Bell?
Micah? You mean Molly?
Molly O'Shea? Sweated her a couple of times, never talked a word, had to let her go. Micah Bell. We picked him up when you boys came back from the Caribbean. And he's been a good boy ever since.
Using your strength, Mr. Morgan.
You're still a yapping dog, Mr. Bill.
Horrible man. Now come on, both of you.
Yeah, we now know Micah Bell was the rat. Not bad.
To John. Where's John?
I don't.
Arthur.
He.
What?
He got killed or he got captured.
No.
I'm really sorry.
No!
Abigail, I was on the train and I didn't see it.
No!
We know that's not true, but...
We got Jack. He's safe. Mrs. Adler.
Because there wouldn't be no Red Dead 1 without
John,
him surviving this.
I want you to know this. He loved you. He loved you and Jack, he did. He wasn't perfect, but he did. Now, you gotta go get that boy. Come on, get out of here.
Arthur, what are you doing?
I gotta go have a little chat before I get much sicker.
No, Arthur.
Don't you owe Arthur me. Neither of you two. Not now. You both know You're good women. Good people. The best. You go get that boy. There'll be time for sorrow later.
If you're headed back there, Arthur, take this. I don't need it anymore.
What's that?
There's a chest in them caves, in the back to the left, hidden under a wagon. Dutch's chest. It's all our money. I know John told you I knew where it was.
Abigail Roberts.
Packed up quick, Miss Grimshaw. Come on, all of you.
Well, we're doing our best.
Hurry, we ain't got long. Hurry.
We just got plenty of time, Micah. We all need to have a little chat.
Black Lung, you're back. Hooray.
I just saw Agent Milton, Dutch. Abigail shot him. She's okay. Not that you care too much about that. You rats. All of you. Seems old Micah was pretty close with Milton.
What the hell are you talking about, cowpoke?
You talked.
That's a goddamn lie.
Dutch.
Dutch. Think of the future.
Milton told me.
And you believe him, Black Lung? You believe him?
It all makes sense now.
No, it damn well doesn't.
Dutch, think.
Dutch, be practical now.
touch!
John?
You left me! You left me to die! My boy, I didn't have a choice. John, I didn't... You! I didn't have a choice. Left me!
What an asshole.
You. You pick your side now because this is over. Oh, them years, Dutch. For this snake.
Be quiet, cowpoke. Be quiet. You live in the clouds.
No, you be quiet, Mr. Bell, and put down your gun.
There's Pinkertons coming fast.
Now! Who amongst you is with me? And who is betraying me? Well, I'm here.
Think for yourself.
He's lying. He's lying.
Put your guns down!
God damn it! Move!
You ready, John?
Yeah.
Everyone get down!
There we go. I knew this was going to be long, but I didn't think they'd be... You jump from one to the other so quickly, but we're going to try to get it done. Since we started it. And then we'll finish it, the rest of it, in the next couple days.
Abigail's safe. So's Jack.
Where are they?
It was Sadie, the Copperhead Landing.
Thank you, brother.
I want you to not look back. Like I said.
Get through this and we'll call it a day.
Pinkerton's on the left! The
Trying. Fucking bullets does it take to kill these people? It's ridiculous. It's not realistic.
Come on, brother. Let's go.
Give me a sec.
Come on. Push, Arthur.
Thank you.
Arthur! Come on, Arthur. Let's go.
Well, what about the money? Abigail gave me the key.
I head down there. I'm dead in 5 minutes. I got a family. That's more important.
Maybe you're right, but...
You want the money? You head down. I gotta go to my family. Arthur.
I'm coming with you. Get you out of this bullshit. If it's the last goddamn thing I do.
Thank you.
Ah, oh, shit. Let's go. We need to find higher ground. Don't worry about them. They'll just be going back for the money. We need to get the hell out of here.
Yeah, we're definitely helping John. John's a good dude.
Here
you go.
Come on, Arthur. Keep pushing.
They're coming. Push it.
Stay down. Get behind a rock. God damn it. They're everywhere. I'm shot.
I wanted to keep this under an hour, but it looks
come
like...
On, let's go.
You go.
Keep pushing, Arthur.
No. No. I think I've pushed all I can.
Come on.
You go.
We ain't got time for this. Not now.
We ain't both gonna make it. Go. Now. I'll hold them off. It would mean a lot to me. Please. There ain't no more time for talk. Go.
Arthur.
Go to your family.
Arthur!
Get the hell out of here and be a goddamn man.
You're my brother.
I know. I know.
Bastards!
Jesus.
You ain't gonna reach that gun. You ain't. You lost, my sick friend. You lost.
Yeah, Marcus. Despite my best efforts to the contrary, it turns out I'm wounded.
And here I said I wasn't going to go over an hour, and we're over an hour. But it is what it is.
It is over. Now, Arthur. It's over.
Oh, Dutch. He's right. You know it, and I know it.
He's sick. He's dying. He's talking crazy.
Yeah, up there on the ridge.
I gave you all I had. I did.
Come on, Dutch. Let's go, buddy. We made it. We won. Come on.
John made it. He's the only one. The rest of us. No. But I tried. In the end, I did.
Come on. Let's go. We can make it. Come on, Dutch. Come on.
A good episode.
close. Too close. We brought that trouble on ourselves.
By we, you mean me.
The one me who went and shot him.
Seemed like he deserved shooting.
I'm sure he did, but I've been thinking, ain't it about time you stop being the man making them decisions?
I'm trying.
Are you?
I think so.
We gotta find someplace to lay low. Keep quiet.
Maybe Dutch was right. Maybe we should have just gone to Tahiti.
Is that it with you? Tahiti or killing? Come on, John. Please, try.
Try what?
We gotta live somewhere for more than just a few weeks.
Okay. Let's see what we can find in Strawberry. What do you know about Strawberry?
I know they like good, honest, hard-working men a whole lot more than angry killers. So make yourself good and honest.
I'm always honest. Maybe not always good, but I'm always honest.
My whole life I've been surrounded by fools with moral codes. Here's the moral code. Look out for folks. Stop trying to act like some hero in a book.
What do you know about heroes and books?
My reading's getting pretty good.
Well, read different books, then.
The books is Jack's. And, well, maybe he's doing most of the reading, but still.
You're a bad influence on your mother, boy. Boy?
Sorry, sir. What was that?
I said you're a bad influence.
We're gonna get him over there to Strawberry, and we'll end it there.
You know that. Boy Calloway and the men from the moon, or whatever it was.
I'll do my best to find better reading material, Pop.
Is that what you like, then? Western tales? Boy.
What's that, sir?
Do you enjoy tales of the Wild West?
Not so much anymore. I've been reading about knights. You know, of the Round Table.
The king. What's his name?
There's King Arthur. And there's Sir Lancelot, and the Lady Guinevere, and a whole lot of others.
Those names.
I kind of like them.
You know what? So do I.
Trying to get there as quick as I can, just because this episode has run too long.
About this place. Been a long time. Here.
I'm gonna go see what kind of good, honest work I can find. Grave digging or polishing some rich fella's boots or some such.
Me too. See if me and the boy can find some laundry work or something.
Help you, son?
I'm hoping I can help you. I saw the help wanted sign outside.
Sure, but you're a bit old to be stacking groceries and running errands, ain't you, son?
Well, I ain't too proud to do nothing. As long as it's honest and it pays.
Time's hard, Mr.
Milton. Jim Milton. Yeah, my wife and I and our boy, we was robbed a few days ago. Lucky to get out with our lives, we was. Now, we need money.
Yeah, there's bad folk out there.
Yeah, tell me about it.
Got a wagon by any chance?
I'm sure.
Well, then maybe you could run some goods up to Pronghorn Ranch for me. You know, head west past Owingila, then follow the road north, leads you right there.
I don't know where that is, but I'm sure I can find it. I can leave right now if you'd like.
It's Getty's place. Fine fella. Where's the wagon?
It's just outside. You know, I should go tell my wife, and then I can come back and get loaded.
Well, my boys can load you up while you go find your wife.
Okay.
Thank you, Doctor. Hey, how you getting on?
I found some work.
Me too.
Delivering goods out to some ranch.
Cleaning a doctor's surgery.
Fine living.
It is, John. Oh, it is. This is the way to it.
I'll take your word on that. What do you suggest now?
I'll stay here. Get on with the work. You deliver them goods and then collect me.
Okay.
And John, I love you. Don't you forget that. Not ever now.
I won't.
Oh, boy. So it looks like we got to deliver this stuff now.
Loading her up pretty good, Milton.
Good.
Now you ride slow now. Yetis don't want his goods damaged.
Of course. Much of a delivery boy. West past Oahela, then follow the road north. Okay.
I think we lost stuff already. The problem is I'm in a fucking hurry. I didn't realize this mission was going to take so fucking long. I would have waited on it another fucking day. It's a problem with this game. It's like you run into one multiple thing after another. Then you can't even stop because you're in the middle of something. You can't save it. I'd like to save it so I can end it. This episode's gone on too long. How fucking far is this shit? I didn't want to sign up for this bullshit. Yeah, it's fucking forever. Jesus. I'd like to find a spot I can save it. Let me see if it'll let me save right here, because I'm so sick of this right now. Yeah, we're stuck. I have no choice. I have to keep playing. We gotta drive all the way fucking back and pick her up. It's like, my God, how long am I gonna be playing this? Probably 2 fucking hours.
This must be it.
See if this is the guy.
You Mr. Geddes?
No, sir. I'm Mr. Dickens, his overseer.
Jim Milton. I'm delivering some supplies from the store in Strawberry.
Okay.
This is quite a place.
Yes, it's beautiful. Oh.
They send everything?
Yeah, I think so.
So, partner, your boss, he looking for hands?
Why? You looking for work?
Yeah. My wife, we was in business with her family and turned sour. It's a long story.
Yeah, I don't know. Married hands. It's a lot of trouble.
I'm a good worker. My wife, Agatha, even our boy, Lancelot. We'll all work.
Big man around, boy? Get the hell out of here. Now, that ain't very neighborly. And threatening us is neighborly. Hey, mind if I enjoy one of these apples? Put that down. Delicious. Oh, when's boss man gonna sell this place, boy? I don't think there's any plans for that. You boys want a drink? It's some fine scotch whiskey. Put that down. Put that down. Oh, these supplies for the season.
Get off the farm.
Come on. We know when we're not wanted.
Get down from there.
Bye, bud.
You come back here.
Take that horse if you need it. Go easy on him. We can't have trouble here.
That's my damn wagon.
Always something. Really, I...
This one's got a stallion. Thank you. Milton, isn't it? Those boys are out of Laramie. Work for Mr. Abel. Thank you.
Don't mention it. Listen, I ain't looking for no charity or nothing, but I was serious. You got work? We'll work. I can do anything. We got robbed ourselves a few days back.
We ain't got married hands here. You're married.
Work harder than any one of them. I'm real honest, and my wife... Even though she's got fancy thoughts, she'll work.
Seem kind of desperate. What trouble you in?
No trouble, sir. Aside from her brother, he tricked us and robbed her of her inheritance. We're good people. We'll work. Even Lancelot.
What does Mr. Geddes need with a boy? Just another mouth to feed.
Just please give us a chance. I can handle myself okay. You know that already.
Yeah. Makes me wonder just who would have robbed you. But we'll give you a chance. I'll let Mr. Geddes know when him and his wife return tomorrow.
Thank you, Mr. Dickens. I'll go get my wife.
No, you stay here. It's getting late. We'll go get her in Strawberry. We'll bring her here tomorrow. We need you around in case any more of them Laramie boys turns up.
Well, maybe at this point we can save
it. There's a cabin out yonder past the ranch house. Things work out, y'all can stay there.
Thank you. You'll not regret this.
Yep. Get yourself settled. We'll have work for you tomorrow when Mr. Geddes returns.
Nice. I think now we can save it. So the wheel is the third and final mission that we did. That being said, we're going to save it so we can get on with our lives. Wheel 63%. Anyway, if you enjoyed the content, thumbs up, subscribe, all that good stuff. We'll see you next time.